H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
For example, when you log in, right, there are so many fields when you're creating an account. So you don't provide the data from Excel sheet. It's a lot of things. So how you handle this kind of functionality is using the description object. Okay, that part I'm going to discuss later. Because you have number of text boxes here. Oh my gosh, am I going to fill all these text boxes with the data? No. What you're going to do is, from your Excel sheet or wherever it is, you're going to mention the account name is different. But the rest of the things, you're going to fill automatically from your script. Only the account name is going to change, because that is the mandatory field. The rest of the things, you're going to fill using the description object. It fill all the data and then it's going to create an account. Okay? That we need not worry about, okay, am I going to pass the local name first or the annual revenue first? No, there is no worries. Right? That answers your question.
Hi, Sam. Can you show what should be the recording run setting?
Sorry?
Can you show in UFT what are the recorded run settings?
Recorded run setting.
Yeah. What you have set in that?
What do you mean by recorded run setting? This one?
Yeah.
I mean, what do you want me to know here?
Sometimes, you know, depends upon the settings also, right? If you have set in on open browser, sometimes it opens a new, I mean, if there is a new browser, it opens a new browser, right? So that's why I wanted to say.
That's what you're doing here, it's just using system, it will not record an answer.
Okay.
So these are different ways how you can add it. So basically, like you can open application using the record and run settings or system entry. But when you are an expert kind of person, like the QTP, you yourself want to project as a QTP tester. So we don't do any kind of this record and run settings, because I want to see. I don't want in the real time from the automation perspective. We try to reduce as many as we can the background settings. All I want is whatever the things I do, mostly that will be visible in the script itself. Okay, that way, instead of using this record and run settings, so we're going to use the system utility directly in the script itself. That way now it will be visible. The moment you open the script, so you know what you're doing, how you're opening the application. So there is no record and run settings. Okay. Instead of using record and run settings, you're using system util.run to open the application. Both does the same way.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, breakpoint, I'm going to talk later, not now, it's too early. Okay, we are learning the basic features. Once you're done with that, then we do the debugging later. So you're not going to open multiple browsers at the same time. because you're going to run your script one at a time. Right? So you have to be clear whether you want to test the Internet Explorer or Firefox. Once you're done with Internet Explorer, maybe you're going to run the same script on Firefox. It's not something like you're going to test Internet Explorer, Firefox, and Chrome at the same time, right? Because the UFT itself will confuse which browser you want to test. That's what most of the time we do. So you're going to test one of the browsers, and then you do testing this week with Internet Explorer, and then you run all your 100 to 100 of 1,000 scripts on Firefox next week. So you have to make sure, basically like you can do all kind of validations, okay? So if the Internet Explorer is already open, then you can close it. You can do all the things as part of your startup, okay? So you can handle any kind of thing. So we're going to slowly learn one by one. Somebody is asking like, is there any other method to close the application process? There are different ways. So even you can say, using this browser, right? That's the browser you opened. So you're going to use this close all tabs also. This is the other way how you can close the application. There are multiple ways. Okay, either you can use system util or you can use browser and then close all tabs. Even you can also use the Windows scripting to close application. There are different ways you can choose any one of them. Okay, most likely either you can use a system util or browser. These are the simple ways. All right, so you can always close, right? Even if the browser is always open, you can always check. So you're going to say if the Internet Explorer is already open, right? So you're going to check. I'm going to run some if-else conditions and then close it. So system util, there is a method or you can also check something this browser, right? Whatever that application you are checking, if you see this browser dot, you're going to check if it exists. That means if it is already open, some condition, then you want to close. Before you open. Okay, there are a lot of things like you can handle. How you want to do the scripting depends on your test scenarios. I didn't understand what's meant by navigating through multiple browsers. Multiple IE browsers. I didn't understand. How to test Windows application that's not coming by default like flight reservation. Any kind of Windows application has executable file. So you're going to provide the executable file here, the path. Okay, if it is a Windows application, this is a web application. If it is a Windows desktop application, so you are going to get the path of this application wherever it is installed, right? So if you have this all programs, that's where, like, you see your application is installed, right? So for example, like say client application is your application. You go to here, right click, right? And then say properties. Assume like client GUI is the application you are testing. Properties, and then copy this target. This is the executable file. Always the desktop or Windows applications, you will get this executable file, exe file. If it is a web application, that is the URL. So copy this path, then mention here. That's it. Okay, if you want to open the Windows desktop applications, go to that application wherever it is installed. Right click, capture this path of the executable file, and then mention here. I didn't get your question. Windows application on remote server. Can you please elaborate your question?
Sam, the question is, you know, we have the type reservation desktop application that's coming default.
Sorry, come again. You're talking about client server database.
Sorry?
What is that?
We have that flight reservation desktop application by default when we get from HP, right? But there are some application that doesn't really, you know, install in your local machine, but they are in the
I answered your question. This is the application that is installed on your system wherever it is installed. Say, for example, your Microsoft Office. You want to test this Microsoft Office. Right click. Then select these properties so that you will get the path. Okay? Just mention that path, the executable file. Yes. Because the desktop applications can test the executable file. This is an executable file.
Yeah, exe, right? Yeah.
Okay. Sarisha, if you want, you can speak. I didn't really understand your question. Yeah, please check your microphone, because sometimes I'm not getting your question. Like you're saying, after entering username and password, it opens the main page, etc. So I didn't get your question. Then what you want? What's the question here? Yeah, please get your microphones, guys, because I want you guys to interact in these sessions. Okay, the next one is, so this is actually like how you do the scripting part. You create the shared object repositories, and then you do the scripting. So this is the basic scripting anyway, so we're going to develop the same kind of scripting going forward. Then the next thing is, what are the actions? So you will get actions, multiple actions, and so on. Let me open my notes. Okay, so what is an action? action is a logical unit that contains the sequence of statements to perform specific tasks. Okay, action is a logical unit that contains the sequence of statements, or it's nothing but a collection of steps. Action is nothing but collection of steps or a collection of statements to perform a specific task. So for example here, whenever you develop the script, by default, UFT is going to create action one. Action one is the default action in UFT. And also all actions are reusable. So default is action one. And also by default, all actions are reusable actions. That means you can, what is reusable? You can reuse the action across the scripts. Reusable actions. Default action is action one. And by default, all actions are reusable. And action is series of statements or the sequence of statements. So for example here, if you look at, this is an action and it contains the sequence of steps. See, this is the action one, test, different steps, sequence of steps. All these steps are part of this action. And also, one script contains multiple actions. You can create multiple actions in one script. Script contains multiple actions. And what are the different types of actions? What are different types of actions is non-reusable actions, reusable action, and actionable actions. So what is the difference between these actions? Reusable action is an action can be called multiple times by the test in which it is stored, as well as by other test. Well, the name itself is right, reusable. Either you can reuse that action within the same test, or you can also reuse the same action across other scripts. You can reuse it within the same test, or you can also use in the other test. Non-reusable actions are, it is specific to that particular script. You cannot reuse them in any script. Non-reusable. Okay, reusable actions can be used in any script. Non-reusable actions cannot be used. Then what is an actionable action? The reusable action becomes an actionable action wherever it is called. Once again, reusable action becomes an actionable action wherever it is called. Okay, so now let's look at how you do this. So how you're going to create multiple actions. So let's create a new test. And basically, like, I'm going to explain the scenario for you. So you can take any application. Say, let's play with the desktop application, something like this flight application. So the scenario is, you want to log in once, right? This is the scenario I want to test. Log in once, create 5 orders, and then log out or close application. Log in once, create 5 orders, log out, or close application, right? So that way I'm going to create multiple actions. I want to create one login action. I want to create one create order action. And then I want to create one logout action. Then I can control this flow. How many times you want to execute each action? Okay, so this will be done once. Okay, so now I'm going to create. Okay, let's quickly record. That way it's quick. So I'm going to open this application from here, click on run settings. And then I can create multiple actions. Okay, so this is the action. Now I'm going to create one more action in the same test. So select here, call to new action, right? I'm creating a new action in the same test. And then I can give the action name, reservation, then click OK. Now I'm going to create this particular part in this reservation action. You see, now the things gets recorded into this reservation action. File new order. So I enter all these details to create the order. Say insert order. Okay, what's this then? Now I'm going to create in the same script one more action called to new action. And this is say closure. Then click OK. And now I'm going to exit this application. File, exit application. And stop. So that way I created multiple actions, right? So I have 3 different actions. You see, reservation and closure. Even you can change this action properties. You can change this name in this flow. Right click and then select action properties. So I want to change this action as login. Click OK. Say yes to this confirmation window. So here there are 3 actions now it's created, right? Login, reservation, and closure. Now what's the scenario you are testing? You want to log in once, create 5 orders, and then log out. That means how you do this create 5 orders. Where to do the parameterization. So what is parameterization? What is parameterization? So data driven testing, right? Data driven testing. You can create shared object repositories and you can do the scripting. Okay, without recording. So here, you're going to test with more data, right? In this case, I want to create 5 orders. So how are we going to do this parameterization part? So you want to do the parameterization of this reservation, right? How do you do? Like, you people know how you do the parameterization using the keyword view, right? So if you click on this keyword view, and then you go to here, say for example, I want to create 5 different orders with different cities and different customers, right? So this is flight from city, and then click on this configure the value button, and then select this parameter option and enter the parameter name, say flight from city. And also here, you should know what is the difference between the global sheet and action sheet. What's the data table? What is the data table?
Excel sheet. It is an Excel sheet to enter the values, data set values.
Yes. So data table is, it is an Excel sheet . Okay, data table is nothing but an Excel sheet that stores the data used by the script. In other words, the script is going to read the data mentioned in the data table. So there are 2 different types of sheets. Types of sheets, data sheets, local and global. Local sheet and global sheet. So what is the difference between the local and global sheets? What's the difference between them? Local sheet data can be used or can be accessed in that particular action. Only this data is specific to that particular, is accessed in that particular action. Or you can say data is specific to that particular action. Whereas the global sheet one, data can be accessed by any action. It is global, right? Data can be accessed by any action. It's more of the global. So that's fair if you look at here, because now you are trying to mention the data that is specific to the reservation action, right? Because I don't want this particular data to be used by any other action. I want this data specific to the reservation action. That's what you are going to select here, the local sheet. And then you are going to mention the data in that particular specific local sheet to that action. Whereas if you mention the global sheet, it is more applicable to the script to all the actions. Okay, now you're going to select this local sheet, then click OK. So that you see, that particular column gets created here in this reservation sheet. Even if you look at the editor view, you see the same thing. Data table, flight from city, DT local sheet. If you want the same thing mentioned in this here, this should be global sheet, DT global sheet. That way you can also directly mention saying that here data table, right? You can create the columns and then you can mention the data. using this editor. So you just double click on here and then mention fly to city. You can also do this way. And then you're going to write down the scripting part, data table. So now it's going to show you that particular column. I'm going to select that column, saying that DT local sheet. That way, you can also mention directly in this editor, the scripting part. Okay. And also, like, it's not case sensitive, whether you mention the L capital or L small, it doesn't matter. VB script is not case sensitive. Similarly, if you want to use the customer name, this is the customer name, right? Double click on this header. And then so you're going to provide create the column name. Then you do the same thing here. Data table. Now it's going to show you that particular column, select that, comma, DT local sheet. Even if you switch to the keyword view, so you see the same thing. Okay, this is the parameter. These are the three columns that are parameter. Okay, so here, basically we are using the local sheet to read data in that particular action. And now we are going to mention the data, right? So, okay, so I'm going to say this is Frankfurt to Paris, that's my name, and so on. So, this is the anyway Excel how you want to handle. So, Portland, so test 2. Say Portland to Paris, test 3. Because you want to create 3 orders, so you mention all those order information. And now, basically, like, what's the scenario? Once you do this parameterization part, then the scenario is you want to log in once. Okay, so I'm going to reduce this one, 3 orders. So log in once, create 3 orders, and then log out once. You can control that flow. So if you go to this GUI test, right, you will get that flow. If you right click on this, then you will get action call properties. Select this. Then, how many times you want to run this action? I want to run once. So, run one iteration. That's good. Right click on this reservation action. Action call properties. That's what actually the reusable actions. You can reuse that action multiple times in the same test. Right? So this is the other useful feature. So you're going to say how many times you want to run this test. So you can say run on all rows. Depends on how many rows in your test is going to execute for all those rows. Okay, run on all rows. Similarly, close up, right click, action call properties, run once, run one iteration only. So that way you can control the flow and then just click on this run buttons so that it logins once, it creates 3 orders and then close the application. So that's how I feel like you can, that's the use of this creating a multiple actions, and then you can control the flow. How many times you want to execute a particular action, so you can enter the data. Okay, so that way it's create for all those rows. And at the end, it's going to close the application. Okay. And then, so now at the end, like you see, you get this results window that shows how many times each action is executed. Right. So this is the action one, the login part. And the reservation part executed 3 times. And then close application is executed 1 time. Okay, so this part, like you see, how many times each action is executed. Okay. So that's one useful feature, like why these multiple user actions in one script. And the next feature is you can reuse these actions across different scripts. Okay, so before we move on, anybody have any questions? That's what, like Mitali. Without recording means you're going to create a shared object record and then drag and drop those objects. Okay. So you're going to create all those object repositories. This application, you learn those objects. Then you do the scripting part. Creating actions also you can do that. So all things you'll get here, all the new actions. You can create multiple actions. So you can create multiple actions in another test. So for example, this is my new test, right? So how are we going to call those actions? So you can say here, call to an existing action, right? Because you already created those actions. Now I want to call login action in this particular test. So you're going to say call to an existing action, because you want to use the existing action in this particular script. Call to an existing action and then select that particular script. So this is a select action script. Click on this button, 3 dots button, right? And then we're going to select the script. I think that's 12. That way you have to properly name the script. So say yes. Then it's going to show you all those actions. You see, login, close job, and reservation from that particular screen. So which action you want to call in this? Okay, I want to call the login. Click. Okay. So once you do that, you see the login action is called. And we talked about external action, right? What is an external action is, if you see here, because you are calling that login action into this particular script, that is an external action in this particular script. Because it is coming externally from different script. So, reusable action will become an external action into a different script. So, login becomes an external action in this particular script. Okay, so that's what actually the external action is. Wherever you call that action, that becomes an external action in that particular script. Okay? So in the solution explorer, it's going to show what are the external actions you are calling in this particular script. So this way, you can call multiple scripts. Even if you look at the action one tab, see, login action is called from GUI test 12. This is GUI test 13, but you are calling login from this particular script. This way you can call multiple actions. Like you want to call, say, close application. So select again, call to existing action, and then select the same script, GUI test one. Then you can say whether you want to call reservation or you want to call the login. You can select that particular action, so that action will be called. See, login is called, and then close up is also called. Now, if you run, so you can open the application, whatever the way, like you can open using system util. Right, so basically you're going to mention the application executable file. Okay, let me copy that path. Then you should be able to run your script, then it calls these actions. So here you didn't create any script, instead you're calling the existing action into the script. That way now, that is the advantage with this reasonable action serve. So you're not going to create the scripts again and again. So you create the reusable things and then use them across different scripts. Then that way you're going to save a lot of time and effort. So that is a call to an existing action. Then what is a call to copy of an action? Call to actions are two types, call to existing action and call to copy of an action. What's the difference between these two? Call to existing action is read only, wherever it is called, right? You are calling just the read only action, which means we cannot make any changes. Cannot make any changes to the action. To the action wherever it is called. Call to copy of an action is read write. You are creating a copy of it locally. So you can make the changes. What it is, say for example here, when I say call an existing action, right? So what is this action? This is the one. When you click this keyword you, it's something, the things are grayed out. You see, I cannot make any changes. I want to put a different agent name. No, I cannot do that because it is read only. I cannot make any changes to this action. Whereas, if I call it as copy of action, right? So if I say insert, okay, then go to this action one. And then, no, you can't make any changes even the editor also. So now, you want to call this as copy of action, right? This is call to copy of action, not an existing action, copy of action. Then select the test. And then I want to call, say, login as copy of action, right? Now, if you see here the difference, it simply says login, but here it says copy of login. That means you are creating a copy of the particular action in this particular script. That is read write. Then you can make the changes. So this is the copy of login, right? Now it is read write. Even if you go to the editor or the keyword view, you can make the changes. Okay. Now I want to do different agent name. So you can make the changes. So that's what it all depends on the need, how you want to use that action. If you really want to make some changes to the action, you're going to do copy of action and then you can modify it. If you say, no, I want to use that action as it is, I don't want to make any changes, then you want to go for existing action. Yeah, basically, like if you say call to existing action, then you're going to make the original action, not in the script where it is called, if you want to make some changes. No. See, basically the global data means, say for example here, in the previous test, right? So in the previous test, if you make, say, instead of the local sheet, and then if you do the global sheet, your script will mess up. Basically what happens is, say for example here, when you're doing parameterization, right? This reservation action. This is the reservation action, right? So when you do the parameterization, so instead of a local sheet, and then you say global sheet, then what it's going to do is going to create now that sheet in the global sheet. So this is the local sheet, but this is the global sheet. What happens is, including your login and close up, it's going to execute three times. Because your global sheet is now talking about three rows of data. This data is applicable for the entire script. Your entire script is going to execute three times. But that's where your script is going to held up. Okay? Your script will iterate through three rows. Entire script, not just the reservation. That's why you're mentioning, no, this data is specific to the reservation. I want only the reservation action to be executed three times with this data. Okay, instead of saying global data. Okay, guys, so that's basically like you can play with this open test, or you can play with this slide, or you can take any application. Maybe if something like this CRM application is not working, so you can also play with some mortgage calculators, or you can work with this one. Something, any kind of this application you can use. So. Okay, so there are a lot of functionality here. So you can select any kind of like the calculators, mortgage or the EMI calculators. So you can play with, you can create any script. Okay. Main thing is you have to understand the concept, how it works. Or you can try with the mortgagecalculator.org. Okay. Play with any applications. And then create this script, what are the things that you need, feasible actions, and that kind of stuff. Well, let me know if you have any questions. All right, so now I'm open for any kind of question and answers. this last 15 minutes. You guys have any questions?
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.